Hey guys, Peter here to do an album review. Today I'm here to tell you about the latest from Fear Factory, Aggression Continuum, out June 18th on Nuclear Blast. This album has 10 tracks, 49 minutes in length, and this is the band's 10th full-length studio album. They are an American industrial metal band. Now, this is a concept record, a record about this post-apocalyptic world of men and machines colliding, nothing new for the band, but a concept that dives deep into the structure of the record, into the soundscape, and obviously the lyrics. Now, when you look at the structure of the album, I think you're going to get two perceptions out of it. The first perception is that the album is very linear, that the songs are really well connected, it moves down a straight path from the beginning all the way to the end, and it doesn't really deviate from that path. The continuation from song to song is helped by creating these intros, interludes, where you have a narrator coming in and allowing to understand better where you are within the concept, within the record, and what the songs are going to be all about. So those elements are really helping the listener stay on path, stay on course as you navigate through this record and not really walk away from it or get off of that ride and try to go somewhere else. It really keeps you focused. It's a very important element that this record has to offer. So this is the first glance. Then once you dive deeper into the record, you start to realize that while the songs use a lot of the same elements, there's a lot of repetition of elements and purpose from song to song. There are other elements that come in and change the nuances ever so slightly of these tracks. So you're gonna get 10 songs that have their own unique fingerprint, their own unique style, their own unique approach, but that they merge really well with the overall big picture. So this album is really designed as a movie. You're gonna get the one idea out of it, which is how the whole record feels like, and then obviously you're gonna get something different on a track by track basis with the necessarily ebbs and flows. As far as soundscape is concerned, this album has a very well-defined sound. It's big, it's powerful, it's demolishing, it's very brutal. It has a little bit of this cinematic, industrial, destructive, heavy, brutal sound to it. It has all those elements coming together in different amounts from different angles, if you will, as you move along. But it's an album that's just really well-defined, and I think that's an important element when you have those many pieces moving, when you have a record that really has a lot of layers to it, and this is an album that has a lot of layers to it, you need to be able to define them so that the listener can really understand exactly what is happening within the songs and obviously what is happening within the experience of the album, breaking down all of those different pieces of the puzzle before you put them all back together to see what the big picture is all about. Within that soundscape, there are three pillars. I would say electronic orchestration as one, guitars and drums. These are the three main cornerstones of this record. When you look at the electronic sound and orchestration, I like the fact that they were not overused. They were used sporadically throughout the record, giving this cinematic vibe to the album and to the songs, but they used them more in tracks that really call for it, that really ask for that more bombastic feel, that more bombastic sound, that expansion of sound, not necessarily contracting the overall experience of the sound on those specific tracks. This has an impact in the overall experience of the album. I really liked it because once again, it wasn't overused. It was used sporadically in the right spots at the right time in the right songs. And every time it happened, every time it came to the forefront, it always felt fresh and new. And that's exactly what you want. If you have some elements that are not changing that much from track to track, you need something that comes in and changes the perception of the listener. To me, the electronic elements and the orchestrations really did that throughout the record. They were almost like reset buttons every time they came in into a song. Next, you have the drums. Very powerful. The drums are really the foundation of this album. They really created the baseline that everything else travels upon it. They are the road, or perhaps if you will, they are the motor of the album. While the guitars are the gas pedal, the drums are definitely the motor. I like the consistency of sound that stays throughout the record. They never really deviate from the beaten path. They stay very well connected. They stay very cohesive, very strong all the way throughout. At times, I felt like they needed to be better defined in their essence, in their sound, in their delivery. I felt that at times they felt a little bit too much contracted, that they were imploding within themselves and not really expanding as much as they could within the tracks and obviously throughout the record. But overall, very consistent sound and not necessarily a problem that really hurts the overall experience of the record. Once you get into the guitars are a little bit more dynamic. I wouldn't go as far as to say eclectic because they're not. They stay consistent, but they're a little bit more dynamic. They have wider boundaries of existence, if you will. Sometimes a little bit more groovy, sometimes a little bit more melodic, a little bit more driven, but always pairing really well with what's happening as far as the drums are concerned in order to give you that demolishing sound that comes at you on almost every single song. It just really feels like you're putting yourself through a blender. That's perhaps the perception that you get when you merge the drum sound and the guitars together. On top of all of this, you have the vocals. This is gonna be the last record with Burton C. Bell. I have no doubts about that. And what a record. I mean, he has a magnificent performance on this album. His clean vocals are phenomenal. His harsh vocals are really well done, really well spotted. The two coming together really allowed the songs to be well defined within their parameters. You start to realize exactly the dynamic that he's giving to the tracks, the dynamic that he's giving to the lyrics, and really bringing those elements to life and making the songs a lot more impactful, helping the songs becoming a little bit bigger within themselves. Overall, there's been a 6-year break between records, and this album is not going to disappoint the fans of the band. This album really feels like it continues the traditions of the past and allows them to just push forward with a lot of momentum, with a lot of intensity, with a lot of aggression. The only downside of this record, like I said, is it feels like it's the turning of a leaf or a turning of a page. With Burton C. Bell leaving the band, this being his last record, once again, I have no doubts that that's going to be the case. It really makes me wonder what the future of the band is going to be. But when I'm listening to this album, I'm not worried about the future of the band. I'm worried about the present. I'm worried about what this record has in store. And this album is a Fear Factory album from the beginning all the way to the end. Just really strong record across all the different elements. Now, as far as songs are concerned, I want to start off with Recode. This is the opening track of the album, and I think this is the perfect intro to the record. It's a perfect intro because of the way it sounds, the way it's put together, the way it's constructed, all the elements that this track has really allow you to understand exactly what the journey ahead is going to be like, what's going to sound like, what's going to feel like. It's just a very interesting song to really open up the album. It has a little bit of an industrial cinematic vibe to it as far as the atmosphere is concerned. It's a thunderous track, has a lot of power, a lot of momentum. The orchestrations really give the cinematic vibe to the track, and you want that at the opening track because you really want to set the table. You want to set the mood of what this record is going to be all about, and I felt like they did that perfectly with this song. The industrial elements that they added ever so slightly here and there, it gives more of a robotic feel to the way this song comes across. Plays really well into the cinematic elements, plays really well into the concept, really well connected. A song that just feels like it has all the right pieces and all the right places. The guitars, drums, and vocals coming together, thunderous, powerful. The heaviness, when those three are pushing in the same direction, this song is powerful. This song is heavy, and they just feel very robust. They feel relentless almost in the way they move throughout the song. There are some more melodic portions within the track, specifically in the chorus, but overall, this is a perfect opener. Next, Aggression Continuum, the title of the album. I love this song. I love the electronic opening at the beginning. It has a really nice intro. Once again, it allows you to understand exactly where you are within the concept, where you are within the record, and what to expect perhaps from the song that you're just getting into. It still has a lot of cinematic elements to it, works really well, is a heavy, brutal track. The drums and guitars really pave the roadmap of what this song is going to be in terms of strength, power, and heaviness. Those two elements really push this song forward together at the same time in the same direction. The vocals add aggression, but I don't feel like they're neck and neck with those other two. They're all pulling in the same direction, but not perhaps with the same amount of force. That's the best way to describe it. Demolishing track moves really well. The clean vocals offer a slight break within the song because otherwise this would be almost too much to bear for the listener. So the clean vocals really give you a little bit of a break, allow you to catch your breath, if you will, but ever so slightly. Overall, the perception that you get from this song when you walk away from it is that was a very brutal and aggressive song. You almost forget about those moments of clarity that you're going to get throughout. Last but not least, Fuel Injected Suicide Machine. I love this track, one of my favorite songs on the album, a more methodic track, if you will. It doesn't feel like it's coming at you with the same kind of energy. feels like it's moving ever so slightly. It's more ginger in the way, it's moving gingerly, if you will, in the way that it's progressing. But I like that approach because it doesn't lose anything as far as heaviness is concerned. And the drums and guitars, once again, working really well together, dictating the tempo, dictating the bursts of energy, dictating the heaviness that the track has, and overall feeling like it's a more controlled song. It doesn't feel like it's about to break. It doesn't feel like it's going to go off the rails. It feels like it's a little bit more controlled, staying within its path from beginning all the way to the end. The chorus is super melodic. That changes the perception of the track ever so slightly, but you get back into that heaviness and you almost forget about it. So it's a song that has interesting ebbs and flows, ups and downs, peaks and valleys, both vocally and musically. You're gonna get out of both elements. It's not like one is moving the song in one direction and the other one in another. The two are kind of working in parallel with each other. But even when the song becomes a little bit more melodic, the heaviness behind it, the drums, guitars, they're still there creating some heaviness to create the perfect bassline to allow the song to feel like it's not moving up and down, that's staying more level, even though there are elements within it that are moving up and down and creating the ebbs and flows. So it's a very interesting track that's very hooky, very catchy, not just from a vocal perspective, but also from a musical perspective. So it's a song that's really a hook, and I like this track because of it, because it's a hook vocally, it's a hook musically. Just an immense, immense song, really powerful track. One, like I said, my favorite on the album. All right, guys, this is Fear Factory, Aggression Continuum, out June 18th on Nuclear Blast. Let me know your thoughts on the band, on the singles. Use the comment section below. I'll be reading those and getting back to you. Take care, guys.